games and shit like that. Back then, I liked watching. Until you start being around the fans enough times, you start liking, man, I hate these motherfuckers, man. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing like a Buckeye fan, because they're not in reality. Hey, boy, man, I said Buckeye fan. Ain't nothing like a motherfucker in Columbus, Ohio. They're not in reality, man. They're in a different reality, man.
That football gets right. You.
So it's the people that made me actually hate this place, man. It's the people.
There's always that family member.
We had it last night.
What the hell? Like the woman's a courageous hero.
Yeah.
Bitch is taking on 500 zombies by herself.
Yeah, yeah. That's the Walking
she's
Dead.
She's saving the day.
Yeah, the Walking Dead, the one woman, man. The older chick. Raven's a part of the book. I can't remember her name.
Oh, you talking about, I like her though. Yeah, I forgot the bitch's name.
I call her adulterous.
They're all adulterous. Fucking Rick Grimes, the main character, is an adulterer. Now he's fucking with Michonne.
Oh, man. That fucked everybody up.
Yeah, it really did.
Everybody was just
sweet. Rick Grimes must be a Jake then. He's trying to get his... You know what I mean?
Yeah. Rick Grimes. Michelle just seduced him somehow.
Yeah. That's all that was available.
Michonne, right. That's all that was available. Neither can he know them, Sir Reckless Todd, but the natural man receives not the things of the spirit of the Most High, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. But he that is spiritual judges all things, and he himself is judged of no man.
That's good.
Known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct you, but we have the mind of
the right, because you know people coming out here, we out here teaching. We the ones that came out here to teach, and people come up trying to teach us.
In order to do that, you gotta twist the scriptures. Like John 3:16.
You want me to be able to read those scriptures? Because you can't get into a scripture, then they got no the
Lovey Dovey, the sequel shit, you're gonna have to add them to this.
You don't have to get it. You ain't gonna be able to read the Bible too much at all.
Yeah, right. If any man shall add unto these things, most I shall add unto him the plagues that are written in this book. If any man shall take away from the words of the book of this prophecy, most I shall take away his part of the book of life.
Right, so then when they say the kingdom of heaven, the Lord going, the all nations are going to be in the kingdom. Where did the Lord came to save all nations? When they say that, they add into the book. You know what I'm saying? When you say all nations can be saved, you add into the book.
Don't you ever want to eat a bite? Eat a bite?
You know how stupid that sounds? Fucking heathen, bro. We ain't going to be... We're going to be up in that chariot with an Edomite, with a Somalian. We're going to be up in a chariot. Can you imagine that?
A real Canaanite?
Up there with a bunch of Hindus and shit, bro. How crazy would that be? Did you know that ain't going to happen? That is not going to happen. You see it, right? Too much liberty. Go ahead.
Second Chronicles 18 and 12. And the messenger that went to call Micaiah was back to him saying, behold, the words of the prophet declare good to the king, who won't consent to sin. Lest thy word therefore, I pray thee, be like one of theirs, and speak thou good. And Micaiah said, as Jehovah liveth, even what my God said, that will I speak.
Truth.
Yeah, so we're going to speak what the Lord spoke. We ain't adding extra words.
Hopefully be offended.
Like, you got preachers and Bible teachers saying it's okay to eat pork. How crazy is that?
Oh, wait a minute. I got something to show you. Well, you got something
for you? Good.
My cousin, man. Last time I actually had a conversation with a person, like the second year of the truth. And he said to me, man, the way for me to make some money is I have to get into the Bible. You know, I have to get into the Bible. You know, I have to get into these churches. Yeah, that's a way of making money.
That's an easy way. Tell everybody that bullshit, you get paid. Get it over here. Let me get it. Just hold it up. I'll aim it in there. Let me see it real quick. There you go. They say you can make a lot of money off that Bible.
Sean Williams.
They say if you want to get become a millionaire, create your own religion, or just teach the Bible.
Piece of shit. Mitch got older, you know, they grew up in the same house. He put locks on the door. He put a locker in her bedroom.
Many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially day of the circumcision, whose mouths must be stopped, who subvert whole houses, teaching things which they ought not for filthy lucre's sake. Yeah, for filthy lucre's sake, as you know, for money. Like he was showing that book of his family member, you know, just sell, making books about the Bible just to get paid, you know what I mean? Just like the dude in the danger from IUIC. Everything, he's just getting paid. All them so-called religious leaders and all these cult leaders, bro, they just in it to get paid.
Deep pockets.
They're not even in it for the spread wisdom and knowledge. They just in it to get paid. If they was in it for the wisdom and knowledge, like Nathaniel's people, wouldn't his people have some knowledge? They don't know shit. We talk to them guys. They don't know nothing.
They gonna let you, man. They gonna hang. They gonna hang. They gonna wake up and hang.
Nothing will happen.
They gonna hang right downtown. Man, they gonna kill them.
What's that one scripture? If it would be of God, it will come to naught. I mean, if it is not of the Most High, it will come to naught. So if it, so. That's how we gonna know. Alright? Like the IUIC, the Most High is gonna break that thing up. It's gonna be a wrap for you guys. Yeah, Nathaniel ain't gonna last forever. But is he immortal? You know what I mean?
Jeremiah, won't be unto the pastors that
say Israel scatters, they think Israelites only come in one flavor, you know what I mean?
Pop out.
cruise control.
Who does shit like that? A jackass?
Yes, right.
It's like, up in Boston. Was that in Boston? We had a big snowstorm a couple years back. And people was jumping out third story windows in the giant piles of snow. And the mayor had to come out and tell people to stop. People was jumping out of windows in the snow. How stupid. I built an ice fortress that year. He said. It was like real life Minecraft. No, I made my own blocks. It was huge. And these little bastard neighborhoods. These little bastard neighborhood kids destroyed it. We caught them out there fucking it up. For no reason, they just jealousy. They did it because they was jealous. They had some little demons. I don't let my boys play with them. They were salty, they couldn't do one like mine. So they had it destroyed. It's that envious spirit. I don't want to kill them little bastards. That took me out. I almost broke my back building that thing. This shit took hours. Dude, you got something you about to read that?
Switching to the
shit.
Axe 5.
On campus, they sent out protesters out there, and they hired people, paid money to help protest. They had strippers out there holding up signs. They, you know, they cost some money to do that.
They was out there for a bit.
So they was
paid by the hour.
We was going out to teach every week to have people protesting us. Protest? Where they do that? They protest the protesters. Instigators out there just trying to instigate shit with us, trying to get us locked up. They did everything out there for like a month or two straight. Yeah. Well, he's out there teaching his Shakespearean. We ain't seen Peraza.
Peraza traveling.
He always brag about it.
Yeah,
like, I was down in Mexico. He's like, how come you ain't going to Mexico?
I was.
He act like he got one on you. I think he Paul or something. He traveling the world. Like, where you get all this money to travel the world? I can barely afford to travel downtown, let alone to another country. I could barely afford gas, you know, but this is traveling to other countries. You gotta have a visa, not visa, passport, I mean. Your passport is like $100-something.
Crazy.
I mean, I'll probably try to get one if I can sooner or later. But that's a good second form of ID. Soon the passport's gonna be on the microchip. Everything's gonna be on that microchip. Passport. Really, I don't even want that shit, man. I don't even want an ID.
Right, not your arms for men to be seen of them.
Oh, yeah. Don't, because people love to brag about how they're helping the poor. Like Peraza. Not to get on Peraza, but he was bragging about passing out sandwiches. You know what I mean? Just bragging about boasting. He wouldn't stop talking about, we pass out sandwiches. Are you passing out sandwiches? You know what I mean? Just like a politician will always announce, well, I just donated $2 million to this fund. Oh, like the Bill Clinton and George Bush charity fund. They always brag about how much money they donated. But really, they didn't donate shit. They kept it all. But they like to boast. Because when you help somebody out, you're not supposed to boast about it. That's between you and the person you helped. You're bragging about, you're this great person. You donated all this money. You paid so much. Right, I was watching Pastor Rob Parsley one day, and he's like, he told some woman, he's like, look under your seat. And she looked under her seat and found a bunch of money. And he's like, see, that was the load. And he was just, you know, he just made a big spectacle out of it. The whole place went nuts, you know what I mean? It made him look like the greatest guy on earth. When that clearly goes against the scripture.
Go ahead. There's the hypocrites doing the synagogues in the streets, that they may have glory of men.
That's all these people looking for, glory of men. That's what Nathaniel's looking for. That's what Zachary's looking for. Zachary is looking for glory of men. Like you do Yakanan right now. He's looking for glory of men. The AAO Avenger. What a loser. Go ahead.
Gabar video just hate that. Yahweh, I don't need no adventure, man. That shit was bad. 80 up, man. Just
80
up.
Man, he's got the spirit of a woman on him. Of a menstruating adulterous woman. That's what he's got, the spirit of a menstruating adulterous woman. That's the spirit of Yahweh. Go ahead.
Verily I say unto you, they have their full. When thou doest alms, let not thy left hand.
Read that.
Thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites are, but they love to pray standing in the synagogue.
Right. Because when you go to church, well, synagogue, but now they go to churches. But what do they do in the churches? Every 5 minutes, let's stand up and pray. When the scriptures say you're not supposed to do that, you're supposed to pray in the closet. You know what I mean? It's a personal, your prayer is a personal thing between you and the Most High. That ain't everybody's business. And that's like the Muslims too, what they do. 5 times a day, they all drop down at the same spot, right in the street. Yeah, who carrying around magic carpets?
My dream of genius.
Yeah. Goddamn Aladdin.
Genius. That was my shit, man, that cartoon. That was a character for the last one.
Oh, that Robin Williams one.
Was it?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. Yeah. Wow, that was a hell of a character.
Yeah, it was.
Barely I said to you, they have their reward. But thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut the door, pray to thy Father which is in secret.
Pray to the Father which is in secret. Right, we pray in your mind when you by yourself. Like, you know how you see people come out here, so they'll be like, will you pray with me? And they want to get everybody hold hands and stand in a circle. That sounds like some pagan shit or something. Want to hold hands in a circle. That's just on tons of shit right on me, man. That's how they try to get you, you know what I mean? And then if you say you good, they're going to look at you like you're the devil.
You see that Trinity. What's his name? The track star, Tyson Gaines' daughter. Her name was Trinity.
Yeah. Got put to death.
Yeah. Yeah. Way to success.
Trinity.
So I killed that young girl. That was a woman, though. Yeah, she was 15, 16. That's a woman. That's a woman being Trinity.
First Thessalonians 2:2-4. But as we were allowed of God to be put in trust in the gospel, even so we speak, not as to please men, but God, which tryeth our heart. For neither at any time use we flattering words, as you know, nor a cloak of covetousness, God is witness.
Flattering words. You know, people always, you watch all these different preachers and teachers, they always use them flattering words. Go ahead.
Nor of men sought we glory, neither of you, nor yet of others, when we might have been burdensome as the apostles of Yahushua.
That's a good scripture though, because we ain't out here on our own program, you know what I mean? And read that last part again. What did that say? That's the way it said it sounds so good.
It says, nor of men sought we glory.
Yeah, we don't seek no glory of men. Okay, we only out here to please Yahweh, so Yahweh Shah, that's it. We don't care what these people think, you know what I'm saying? If we care what people think, we wouldn't even be out here, you know what I mean?
Neither of you, nor yet for others, that we might have been burdensome as the apostles of Yahweh Shah.
All right, hold on a second.